Therefore, Arjun has been instructed here that all paths, however noble and great they may be, are all but means and not an end in themselves.
That's another very important thing. They are just means that's not going to give you the final. And there are people, you know, there are complete different side of it. ये food से regulate करते हैं लोग. और जो जो साधु संत महात्मा जो लोग घूमते हैं ना इतने क्या बोलते हैं हिमालय पे, वो भिक्षा लेके खाते हैं. कैन यू बिलीव दैट? उसमें दैट मीन्स उसको जो दिया वो खाना पड़ेगा. वो ही कैन नॉट सिट देयर एंड से ये अच्छा नहीं है, किसने बनाया ये वो. बट दे आर एट अ डिफरेंट लेवल. दे हैव ऑलरेडी क्रॉस दैट लेवल विच इज गोइंग टू अफेक्ट देम लाइक दिस. दे आर इन मच हायर स्टेट ऑफ माइंड. See that how much there is a range of this whole thing. So we cannot think that, oh, food is going to control everything. No. If you can go beyond the food also, you know. Or, but for general people, yes, it does affect. And we are still in that category. So by regulating our food, we can definitely improve our mind, body and pranas. There's no doubt for us, for at least this group, you know. So.
In all the above enumerated 12 different yajna techniques, self-effort is a common factor, and therefore the Lord says.
So this is going to be the next one. And since we have a shorter time today, so I'm going to go to Kathopanishad. Kathopanishad, the subject has already started and is pretty heavy. Any question or comment on this particular verse? I think everybody got the gist, right? Everybody okay with it? Okay. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja aham tva sarva papebhyah moksha ishyami ma shujah harihi om shri gurubhyo namaha hari om. In Kathopanishad verse 13 we are going to be we didn't read the whole thing. We're in the middle of
page 100.
Yes. I'm going to just do the prayer and we'll start. Om Sahana Vavatu Sahanau Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahai Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om. So we finished the lodged in the innermost recess, that whole four paragraphs we finished, and we were at hidden in the cave of the heart. Am I right? That's the marking I had done, huh? Okay. Any volunteer to read? Continue reading. And just to remind you,
I can read.
You can read. Very good, Sneha. So just want to remind you that we are on a verse 12. Where he talked about that, you know, how a person, dhir person means like a wise person who has renounced joy and sorrow. And how did he renounce? By recognizing this self, which is, and they are giving you all different indicative definitions, it's called. And we already saw what was Puranam, ancient. Purana hote hai, we nava, because no change usme nahi hota hai. We already did that. And the second one we did was lodged in the innermost recess. You know, means, you know, tumhare core mein hai wo ekdam, you know. And then we saw how the subtle it is. Subtle means ye nahi ki chota sa koi chupa hua hai. Subtle means it's all more pervasive. That's all it means. And subtle means. And then, so now we are going to read from hidden in the cave of the heart. So, before we go into it, Swamiji explains that when they talk about heart, it is not that pumping heart that we talk about in the modern. Usko hum log heart bolte hain, ek machine ko hamari body ki. Jab hum log spiritual heart bolte hain, usme wo different hai. To wo kya hai ki we have an intellect, we have emotions and we have intellect. So mind and intellect, dono hai. So agar koi khali intellect use karega na, उससे भी भगवान नहीं मिल सकता, बिकॉज वो एकदम प्योर लॉजिक ड्राई हो जाएगा एकदम. ओके, खाली इमोशन में बह जाएगा भक्ति में तो भी नहीं होएगा, बिकॉज वो ओवर इमोशनल होके गड़बड़ हो जाएगा. उसका जब मिक्सचर होता है ना, दोनों का मैरिज होता है और वो एक हारमोनियसली होता है, उसको बोलते हैं स्पिरिचुअल हार्ट. वो वाले पॉइंट से जब जब तुम्हारा इमोशंस एंड लॉजिक मिलता है साथ में, उस पॉइंट से ना अच्छी अच्छी भावना उत्पन्न होती है. लव, कंपैशन, ऑल द गुडी गुडी स्टफ दैट वी ऑल क्रेव फॉर अस टू हैव एंड वी वॉन्ट टू सी इन अदर पीपल, दैट कम्स फ्रॉम द स्पिरिचुअल हार्ट. सो जस्ट कीप दैट इन माइंड दैट वेन दे टॉक अबाउट हार्ट, दैट्स व्हाट दे आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. And with that, we will read. Sneha, go ahead.
It's an ancient Aryan concept sanctioned by the Vedas and acceptable even today, that in the cave of the heart is the seat of true intelligence. To a modern microscope gazer, whose philosophy rises no higher than the principle of see to believe, this statement may read absurd, for to him, intelligence is lodged in the brain. But if he walk from the laboratory to the library, listen to the opinion of great authors of what true intelligence is, we shall even today hear quite a different story. The immortal Shakespeare himself has caricatured more than one of his immortal characters to show that pure intelligence, divorced from the softness of emotions, amount to brutality and villainy.
So, yahan par, you know, you saw that firstly, when we talk about heart, we think that it's only like, you know, left side of our body and all that. But a spiritual heart pervades the whole body. That's one difference. Okay. And the second one he's talking about is that how, if intelligence is divorced from the softness of emotions, then it is not a good intelligence at all. So a true intelligence is where jisme thode emotions bhi ho, lekin jyada nahi. You know, balanced ho. So that's what it is. The whole thing is about balance.
All poets and men of letters, philosophers and thinkers, in short, all but the matter-of-fact scientists, roar in unison that enduring thoughts can bubble up only when an intellect is sweetened by the syrup of the heart.
So everybody understood, right? That the good, all the good comes when there is a mixture of the two. Then not good comes, huh?
In spiritual self-discovery also, an intellect tempered by the qualities of the heart alone can be of service, and this truth is pointed out by the general acceptance in the Vedas that intelligence resides in the cave of the heart, and self-realization is gained through a controlled application of a happy synthesis of both the head and the heart.
So ye jo spiritual heart hai na, usko properly develop karna is a main thing for meditation, you know, so we have to develop this. Or rather than develop, we have to seek it. All of us have it. That's another thing. It's not like hum log kuch bana rahe hain usko. Hamara nature hi wo hai, magar uska imbalance ho gaya hai hamara. So we are bringing it into balance so that we come to that point. And udhar se intuition bhi aata hai. When we talk about what is intuition, it comes from there. Go ahead. Gaya
varestham, seated amidst miserable surroundings. To an ordinary man, steeped in his own delusions and living the life of slavery to his own desires, passions and loves, ideas, hopes and ambitions, no negativities as jealousies and hatreds. Indeed, the cave of the heart is even in a medley of maddening thoughts. In the midst of these, the samasarin's intellect, overworked and exhausted, weary and forlorn, is not at all efficient to ponder over the transcendental truth and the nature of the self, hence the aptness of this expression.
So there is that one word that I had discussed about, it's called gavareshtam. And usko Tejumay Anand ji ne bola tha ki it is used for a ghana jungle. Kyunki hamara wo sabke paas ye spiritual heart hota hai. Lekin uske upar ye sab problem aa jati hai na, jo unhone jo description diya hai, you know, own desire, passion, love, hate, ye wo, ambition, negativity, उसके बीच में छुपा हुआ है ये, यू नो, बिकॉज अवर हार्ट इज देयर एंड दैट्स वेयर द, यू नो, इट क्या बोलना चाहिए, ब्रह्मन का एक्सप्रेशन वहां से होता है. एंड द वे दिस इज अंडरस्टूड इज लाइक यू नीड अ मीडियम फॉर द सन्स लाइट टू रिफ्लेक्ट. सो जो एक एकदम पत्थर ले लो और एक शीशा ले लो, विच इज अ बेटर मीडियम फॉर इट टू रिफ्लेक्ट, वेयर यू कैन सी द सन, यू कैन सी इट in the mirror because it's reflecting as it is. That's how our spiritual heart is. It reflects Brahman. But uske upar ye sab negativities ki wajah se hai. So what they are trying to tell you, jahan par ye negativities vagara vagara hai na, usi ke andar chupa hua hai. Now everybody got the whole idea that what they are talking about. And then we discussed it, ki agar snake aur rope ko aap loge, to aapko snake, jahan rope hai, wahi dikhai degi. You know, snake is not going to be seen in opposite direction. So the same way, Brahman is in the midst of all these things. He's talking about. That's the whole. It's a little bit maybe difficult concept, but if you think about it, wo apne aap clear ho jayega what they are trying to tell you.
See, apne jo mind hai, tum ek jagah ho, tum agar only jealousy aur ye lower side dekhoge, to higher side tum dekh nahi paoge. So that's where you have to use your own vivek. See what you want to see.
True. And so what basically they are trying to do is jahan tumko jealousy hoti hai na, usi ke niche chupa hua hai wo. And then remember I had told you ki ek baar wo Shri Shri Ravi Shankar ne kitna acha definition diya ki we all are made of pure love, but what same love when it gets messed up, it becomes like a greed or becomes like an attachment. It's like a vikrut ho gaya wo, you know. उसका चेंज हो गया इनटू समथिंग नेगेटिव. दैट्स ऑल इट इज. इंग्रेडिएंट वही है. देखिए कोई खीर बनाने की जगह उसने कुछ गलत चीज बना ली तुम्हारी माइंड ने. यू नो दैट्स ऑल इट इज. यू नो
इफ द सेल्फ इज दस इनकॉम्प्रिहेंसिबल एंड अनोएबल डज इट नॉट अमाउंट टू डिक्लेयरिंग दैट इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू नो हाउ टू रीच दिस परफेक्शन स्टेट. And the Indian philosopher is not satisfied by a mere view of life which cannot be realized as a practical subjective experience. In this very stanza, true to the spirit of the Indian thought and practical ambition of the Aryan seekers, therefore there is a pointed declaration of a way of life or a technique by which seeker can come to experience this state of perfection.
सो ही सेइंग बेसिकली ही सेइंग कि अगर ये सब सुन के हम लोग ओ माई गॉड इज इट पॉसिबल लाइक हम लोग को मिलेगा या नहीं कभी ये कभी हम लोग डेवलप कर पाएंगे कि नहीं स्पिरिचुअल हार्ट. सो ही सेइंग कि जो हमारा वैदिक शास्त्र है ना वो रेमेडी पे भी बहुत ज़्यादा ध्यान देता है. ऐसा नहीं कि तुमको बोला हाँ भाई गो सीक इट एंड देयर नॉट टेलिंग यू व्हाट टू डू. एंड देन होल भगवद गीता यू नो आई टोल्ड यू दैट इट इज ज्ञान एंड योगा मीन्स अ पैथ टू इट. And that usko kitna jada importance diya unhone path ko. So it's going to tell you, and then the next thing is going to come, and I had discussed it, but here they will do it again. Adhyatma yoga. How do you get to this point? By adhyatma yoga. So here, go ahead, read.
Adhyatma yoga, the technique of meditation. This is the only place where this word appears in this Upanishad, and so it is very difficult to ascertain what Yama meant by it. As a matter of fact, this is the first occasion in the entire literature of the Upanishads we have mentioned of yoga as a term. Yoga, the word comes with the root yuj, to join or unite. Earliest usage of this root was in the sense of yoke horses, bulls, and so on. It is later that the word developed into a complete shastra, and today it has the meaning of exertion of discipline, activity of the body. And with references to the mind, it means concentration or control through meditation. Shankaracharya therefore combined both these meanings and says yoga is deep meditation, samadhan. With thoughts withdrawn from external objects.
So they are telling you a very important thing here. History of the word yoga came first time in Kathopanishad when they talked about Adhyatma yoga. And we already know that these days when they talk about yoga in the West zone, 90% they're talking about body exercise, asanas. Just asana pe atak gaya bas. But basically, yahan par Shankaracharya ji ne bataya ki it is like a, you know, concentration and control through meditation and all that. So basically, the whole idea is connecting to the higher. To me, that's the best definition. You know, your goal is to connect to the higher, unite with the higher, not even connects. Unite is a rather better word. And anything you do in that, but here they're talking specifically about how to realize that Brahman. So that's why they have the Adhyatma Yoga. So Adhyatma Yoga ka, if you have to define in two sentences, it is withdrawing from the worldly things, connecting to the higher is Adhyatma Yoga. And all those yajnas that we talked about, they purify our mind in such a way that we easily connect to it. That's the, you know, whole thing. We are trying to bring Bhagavad Gita here and connect it, you know.
In this initial stage of its career, yoga as used in Kathopanishad indicates a positive meaning of meditation, while in its later history, as in Patanjali Yoga Shastra, it is gained in almost a negative aspect, namely sense suppression and a morbid retirement from bodily activities.
So he's just telling you two different approaches. You know, later on Patanjali, you know, it became more withdrawing and things like that. But here it is more positive. And both are okay, whichever way you want to take it. That's up to you. Both will give you benefit. Either you can take it how, you know, Kathopanishad is saying, or you can take it how Patanjali is saying. Both are okay.
What is this morbid retirement from bodily activities?
Because, you know, usme, like Patanjali mein na, it starts with yam, niyam, you know, control. Aisa karke start hota hai na sara. So iske liye, he's just using that language. That it sounds like, you know, ye mat karo, wo mat karo, nahi, 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 nahi. Aur yahan par wo positive mein ja rahe hain, you know, that you know, connect to this Brahman, which is like all bliss, all this thing, you know. You see how you can look at it with either way you want? That's what it's saying, yeah.
The impossible is achieved through the process of self-perfection called meditation. Meditation is the process by which a purified mind, and therefore a highly concentrated mind, is brought to contemplate exclusively upon the nature of the Atma through a total avoidance of mind, the mind wandering into any other object of contemplation. This process of making the mind think solely through an appointed channel of thinking to the total effective exclusion of all dissimilar thoughts, currents eroding in its into disturb and muddy the planned channel of thought, can be successful only when the meditator is weaned away from all its gross negativities.
So see here the two points that they mentioned, that for meditation needed purified mind and concentrated mind. Any of these two things are lacking, you will not be able to sit in meditation. So that's why Krishna Bhagwan told Arjun, for you, Karma Yoga is better. Why? Because he knew ki if he prematurely goes into meditation, he will fail at it. You know? So if we are not able to sit in meditation, then that means we need to purify our mind more and we need to make it more concentrated.
Such a successful meditator, meditating long upon the nature of truth as evident within himself, in the sacred spirit of his practices, comes to gain an intimate subjective experience of Godhood. Though the ordinary means and methods of getting our day-to-day objective knowledge are not available in seeking or knowing or realizing truth, there is a special method by which we can develop our powers of intuition, which are now lying dormant in us beneath the thick layers of our own patterned incrustations, and by which we can experience the Atma. This technique of communion with the self is the exact significance of the word Adhyatma Yoga here.
So he's just reminding you that jo worldly knowledge hum log jis method se gain karte hai na, wo yahan par chalta nahi hai. You know, it is a totally different method. And the method is that, you know, we are, it's a subjective science, and, you know, purity of mind is everything. And then what we are trying to get out to is lying dormant in us, you know, this thing. And because of the thick encrustation, we have put a layer on all these things, negativities. We are trying to reach there. That's all it is. As much as negativity will come out, it will उभरता जाता है अपने आप ही, you know. It's not like we try to gain something, you know. It is you just keep removing और वो shine होता जाएगा अपने आप. I think it's amazing if you think about it that way. You really don't need to do any special practice or anything, you know. It's just purity of mind somehow you have to gain.
Yes, pure, the more pure you're becoming, the more you'll connect with yourself.
Yes.
And yourself is the Atma only. And
yes, so, there you go. Yeah.
And that's what
that's what the whole journey is about, right? That's what you're talking about. Yeah.
If truth is so subtle, the process so very complicated, the chances so rare, the percentage of success so meager, then is it not sheer madness to renounce and to go into a quiet cave in some Himalayan jungle to suffer privations, to starve out the body, and to keep vigil over mere fantastic ideas, unrealizable and imperceptible? Is it not far better to live here, sweating and toiling, weeping and sobbing, sighing and laughing, dancing and reveling? To one who asks these questions, there is no real answer. If he is so low as to do nothing more than a two-legged animal, not even the crudest of religions dares to serve such a low worm man. How then can Brahma Vidya, which is the last textbook in religion, meant to guide a full man to the very state of Godhood, cater to the worm man? But if the questioner is the one who has lived life intelligently and has come to the same conclusion that even the best that it can give is but the hornet's nest of imperfections, sure to provide endless sorrows and pains, to him is the Upanishad addressed. And it is to such sadhaks or aspirants that we have here in this stanza a declaration of the result gained when the Adhyatma Yoga is pursued and the realization of the self is attained. The text says that such one renounces with both joy and grief.
So I know it's such a long paragraph with so many long sentences. Basically, it's telling you that a person who has lived the life and realized ki main sansar mein kitna bhi kuch kyun na palu, it is going to be just the hornet's nest imperfection, meaning a large amount of worldly activities, constantly busy, end mein kuch satisfaction kuch milta nahi hai. जिसको ये मालूम पड़ गया है ना, वो ही इसके लिए रेडी है. जस्ट लाइक नचिकेता वाज, ओके, बिकॉज इट्स लाइक. बट इफ सम पीपल यू मीट एंड दे से, यू नो व्हाट आई टॉकिंग अबाउट अदर लाइफ बिफोर लाइफ, दिस इज ओनली लाइफ, यू नो, खाओ पियो मजा करो, उन लोगों के लिए नहीं है ये उपनिषद फिर, यू नो. लेट देम बी इन दैट हॉर्नेट्स नेस्ट, यू नो. बट द वन हुज कम टू दैट रियलाइजेशन that there is something beyond unke liye hai, that's basically uska gist wahi hai.
Yeah, thoda to kuch realization ho chahiye tabhi to tum is path par bhi walk kar sakte ho, nahi to
that's why, you know, some people they start something and then they just give up. Or like the other classic thing is zara sa kuch negative hua life mein, oh kaun bhagwan ji, you know, I don't care. So then unke liye nahi hai phir woh.
The emanation hall of samsara is stacked with the pairs of opposites.
Dvandvas.
Such as heat and cold, joy and sorrow, success and failure, praise and insult, and so on. The self-perfect saint or sage in this experience, godliness and knowledge, becomes the very illumination or the knower of the opposite states of the mind, and thus becomes a mere onlooker or witness of the varied experiences of life. He thus rises, as it were, above the tyranny and persecution of the moment-to-moment experiences in life, and thus is the glory of a God-man who comes to live and bless the world by his mere presence.
So he's telling you that last part of this verse where he talked about that a dhir purush, I think there is some noises are coming anyway. Last part is ki jo is pe realize kar leta hai Brahman ko, wo dvand se upar uth jata hai. Then he just becomes an observer, a witness. It's like he knows that this is all happening in Prakriti. You can apply it the way you want now, because we have learnt all that in Bhagavad Gita also. That all everything belongs to the Prakriti. Phir woh usse affect nahi hota, woh transcend kar leta hai. The thing doesn't go away, like we talked about it. You likes and dislike, you don't come under the sway, you can call it, or you transcend them. And they are there. He's all very much part of the world. He can be a sadhu in a jungle, or he can be sitting in a cave, or he can be a CEO of a Fortune 500 company. That does not matter, but he rises above these things, you know, duality. He may be doing all the worldly
stuff.
Easy
to say, but it's very difficult to do.
अगर स्नेह इफ इट वॉज इजी तो हम लोग इतना स्टडी क्यों करते और वो बुद्ध भगवान बैठते क्यों ट्री के नीचे कई वर्षों तक. बट इट इज अ इंटरेस्टिंग जर्नी टू. दैट्स हाउ आई लुक एट इट. यू नो दैट द मोर वी काइंड ऑफ स्टार्ट बिलीविंग इन इट, इट हेल्प्स अस इन आवर लाइफ. शुरू शुरू में बहुत डाउट्स होता है, बहुत ये होता है. वंस यू स्टार्ट इमर्सिंग मोर इन टू इट, It does. Like Swamiji says, you know, the self-realization ekdam se nahi hota. It's like a flower that slowly opens. You cannot take a kali and say, oh, open it now and start doing that. Woh bhi khar jayegi. But, you know, pata bhi nahi chalta hai. Dheere dheere hota hai. I mean, that's how I felt when I started my study group. In the beginning, I used to be a lot more agitated, this, that. Then it becomes a little better. I'm not saying, you know, everything goes away suddenly and all, but your threshold becomes a little better. Yeah.
Isn't it true that your feeling of the opposites, joy and sorrow, slowly and slowly and slowly, the effect decreases?
Yeah.
It's a whole process.
Yeah, true. So, you know, and, you know, the person who is like self-realized, sometimes it's hard to judge them, because when in their world with the other people and all that, they will behave like them. But inside, their psyche is totally different than ours. You know, that's what is the main thing, that how do you feel in the deep in your own heart? That's where you feel the change. Upar se to kuch bhi ho sakta hai, no? So... It is 12. What we can do is, instead of starting anything new, I can stop here. We can have 10-15 minutes of discussion. Huh? Does it sound fine? And then I will close at 12:15. Any question on this though?
No, just to comment. I was thinking, we have spent years and years on our education. You know, from childhood, kindergarten onwards, itne saal padhai kari hai, just to be whatever we wanted to do in life. So, ab we are at that stage jahan aur kuch saal padhai kar le to achieve what is really of value. You know, this will not come easily, but we can devote that time now.
Yeah, you can devote more time for sure now.
We can. And then we should be willing to devote that time now, because this is a different kind of education, and I think much, much more valuable than the earlier education that we received. I mean, I'm just thinking that now.
See, one of the very important thing about Bhagavad Gita is that, you know, in the beginning when Arjun became grief stricken, right? So Krishna Bhagwan ne usko highest knowledge sabse pehle di, and then uska analysis ye hai ki जो ग्रीफ होता है ना हमारा, ये वर्ल्डली एजुकेशन से नहीं जाता है. राइट कितना भी हम PhD कर ले, कुछ भी कर ले, हमारा ग्रीफ नहीं जा सकता उससे. ग्रीफ खाली आत्मज्ञान से ही जाता है. उसका वैल्यू है ये.
सो मैंने कहा कि उस एजुकेशन में इतना टाइम लगाया लाइफ में, अब इस एजुकेशन में भी लगाना चाहिए, या लग जाए तो अच्छा.
सो जो आप जो बोल रहे हो ना, तो पहले जो गुरुकुल का कॉन्सेप्ट होता था ना, वो उनको दोनों शिक्षा दी जाती थी साथ में. एंड आई टेल यू, इट इज एज साइंटिफिक मेथड एज इट कैन बी. कि तुम उसको वर्ल्ड, ये नहीं कि भाई खाली अध्यात्म में बैठे रहो, दुनिया भी तो चलानी है. सो वो लोग को सारी कलाएं सिखाते थे. इनफैक्ट व्हेन आई वेंट टू दैट कृष्ण भगवान वे गुरुकुल में, उन्होंने वहां 64 दिनों में 64 विद्याएं ली. तो वो 64 विद्याएं दी हुई है, उसमें सब कुछ है. खाना बनाना आना चाहिए, सिलाई करनी आनी चाहिए, संगीत आना चाहिए. ये नहीं कि भाई खाली अध्यात्म पढ़ लिया, अध्यात्म योग कर लिया. नो, टू लिव इन द वर्ल्ड यू नो नीड टू नो ऑल दैट, बट यू नीड टू नो दिस ऑल्सो. सो अगर एक आइडियल्स देखें ना, इनफैक्ट दे द चिन्मया मिशन हैज स्टार्टेड अ यूनिवर्सिटी नाउ इन इंडिया एंड द होल आइडिया इज दिस दैट टू गिव देम वैदिक एजुकेशन एंड द वर्ल्डली थिंग साइड बाय साइड.
बट ऑल्सो एजुकेशन से ही नहीं सब कुछ हो सकता है. इवन कितने भी अपन ये भागवत गीता 10 दफे पढ़ लो, बट द मेन थिंग इज अपन को मनन करना चाहिए एंड वी हैव टू रिफ्लेक्ट एवरी डे कि अपने एक्शंस आज क्या हुए थे. You know, how we can improve ourselves, that is more important now in this stage of our life.
Yes, yes. And that is part of the way this whole Vedic thing, and it is coming in the next verse. You know, whatever Sneha said, that's exactly what is coming. Shravanam, Mananam and Nididhyasan. And they have used three different words for it, but the idea is exactly the same. Because this particular education requires all three. Otherwise, what Sneha is saying, you can become a pundit and give discourses and hold the classes and all that, but it doesn't become your own nature then. You know, वैसा भी होता है. So for, if you want truly to kind of get this, then you have to do that mananam. Mananam is a huge part of it. True. Anybody else wants to share any thought?
Sneha, while you are there, let me wish you a very happy birthday.
Oh, it is Sneha's birthday today. Yeah, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Kamla's also.
Kamla, happy
birthday.
Oh, really? Kamla ji has a new granddaughter also. Mm. It's very cute.
Today. Kamla's your birthday today. Happy birthday.
Yes. Thank you.
Let's have a party.
It's not yours. Chal chuti.
पर मीरा मना को क्या फर्क पड़ता है उनको के स्नेह को और कमला को केक खिला रहे हो, मुझे भी खिला दो.
वो तो अकेले थोड़ी ना खाएंगे, सब मिलकर ही खाएंगे.
हाँ तो स्नेह अपना केक काटो, हमें आधा दे दो.
एनी टाइम.
देखो देखो कमला ने तो हलवा बनाया है.
Oh wow, it's too bad that we are
I don't dip in cake much white flour, so I made halwa this morning.
ठीक है, हम सारे
halwa खाओ, मजे birthday मनाओ.
I wish we were meeting in person, तो जरूर halwa खाते आज. नहीं नहीं, halwa के लिए we can do drive by halwa.
नीलू जी always has a very good idea.
Most welcome. अभी देखिए, मैं दिखाती हूँ मैंने कितना घी बनाया है. Look at this. Can I show you?
हाँ, show it.
हाँ, nice. दिखाओ please.
Oh my God.
Oh. What? Oh. दुकान खोली क्या कमला जी?
All this we have made today.
घी किस लिए बनाया है इतना सारा?
हलवे में डालने के लिए.
बहू को खिलाएगी ना?
बहू को खिलाऊंगी. और मैं सारी कुकिंग घी में ही करती हूँ. हमारे घर में सिर्फ घी यूज होता है. We don't use any oil except frying.
You know, I have started using ghee for 1 year for all my cooking. And मेरे टेस्ट रिजल्ट्स जो आए हैं ब्लड के, वो डॉक्टर कहता है कोलेस्ट्रॉल बढ़ गया है तुम्हारा. But I don't know if it is because of ghee.
अच्छा, रिमेम्बर मीरा जी, मैंने क्या बोला कि जब आहार का होता है, इट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी बैलेंस्ड. डोंट ओवर डू एनीथिंग फॉर गॉड सेक. इवन जैसे कि इवन पंजाब में लेके मेरा जब या सी, हम लोग की एक्टिविटी कम है ना. सुनो, अगर जो एक इंसान खेत में काम करता है पूरा सुबह से शाम फिजिकल, वो पचा लेगा उसको इतना बड़ा सारा घी दोगे तो. घी इज वेरी गुड, ओके, डोंट मिसअंडरस्टैंड मी. इनफैक्ट माई हस्बैंड विल टेल यू टू, घी का पूरा एक लेक्चर दे देंगे वो, कितना उसमें मतलब तेरा ब्रेन के लिए भी बहुत अच्छा है उसमें. सो घी इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग, बट रिमेंबर, लिसन टू योर बॉडी, लुक एट योर एक्टिविटी अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट यू हैव. सो इफ यू आर ओवर डूइंग ऑन घी, यू कैन डेफिनेटली मेक इट लेस. डोंट कंप्लीटली रिजेक्ट इट, डोंट ओवर डू इट.
And the main thing is increase your activity. That's the key to good health.
And even Kamla ji, you keep saying increase the activity. Some people have the opposite problem. They won't sit down. टू देम वी कैन नॉट से दैट. सो आप जो बोलते हो वो भी एक बहुत बैलेंस रूप में लेना पड़ेगा. आप किससे बात कर रहे हो उसको पूछो. अगर वो उसकी ही इज़ अ वेरी डल पर्सन, यू नो, कोई बहुत ही तामसिक होके बैठा हो कि भाई उठ ही नहीं रहा है बेड से, उसको बोलो एक्टिविटी करने को. फिर जब बहुत ज़्यादा एक्टिविटी हो जाती, नो, यू सिट डाउन एंड मेडिटेट नाउ, इनफ और रनिंग अराउंड यू डिड. सो देन तामसिक में सात्विक में जाओ, सॉरी तामसिक से राजसिक में, राजसिक से सात्विक में.
That's why our rishis emphasized that get up in the morning, do your adhyatma first thing in the morning, so that whole day your activities are guided by that positive energy. Whatever you do, then it becomes karam yoga for you. So that adhyatmic yoga is very, very important. That meditation is very important in the morning. In all our shastras, it has been emphasized that do that in the morning and then be busy whole day. But then your intellect will be guided towards that positive thing of life. Nobody can be as busy as I am. But
Kamala ji, you want me to tell you the truth? I have not met one person in America who says I'm not busy. You know?
Yeah.
So we cannot, and you know, like everybody has 24 hours in their life. And then everybody fills it up with what they want to do. But one of the problem is, so hum log ko ye vehm ho jata hai ki main to bahut zyada busy hoon. No, everybody has the same thing, but they fill it up with different things. You know?
Yeah.
That's a way of thinking that we have to develop, that, hey, you know, what am I want to do with my 24 hours? Some people like too much, and if you are very, very active, like in America, that is a problem that the new generation has. They cannot wind down because they may not be doing physical, but whole time their mind is engaged in five different activities and the phone. So then they need to learn that not to give up that and just maybe just go sit down somewhere under a tree or something for 15-20 minutes. It becomes imperative for them not to run around with this, their own physical run around nahi hai, if you think about it. Mind se run around kar rahe hain.
Yeah.
Aur ek zamana tha jo hum log physically run around karte the bahut. You know? In fact, when I joined the Chinmaya Mission, that's what our teacher said. Whole time, you know, one pole se dusre pole pe bhag rahe ho, kai ke liye? You know? So sit down a little bit. So these whatever statements we make, it's, we cannot make general statements because it depends on where you are in your life, what kind of balance you have to create in yourself. You know?
I agree with Uma that you should try to do nothing. When you don't do anything, the universe will drive you what you're supposed to do. And that is the right thing for you. And which is not same as for the other person.
And that's why you sit in the morning. That's why you sit in the morning, do nothing. Just
no, morning I'm sleeping.
See, मैं बात बताऊँ, ये morning की जो आप बोल रहे हो ना, हमारी मेरी जो आचार्य थी ना, she was very practical also. So she said कि I know the शास्त्र में बोलते हैं कि भाई सुबह meditation करना चाहिए. समझो कोई एक हाउस वाइफ है, उसको 20 काम है सुबह, एंड शी जस्ट कैन नॉट सिट इन द मॉर्निंग बिकॉज शी हैज 20 डिफरेंट ड्यूटीज, एवरीबडी डिपेंडिंग ऑन हर. इज परफेक्टली ऑल राइट टू डू इट एट नाइट बिफोर यू गो टू स्लीप. ओके,
या
एग्जैक्टली. सो देन देर इज नो लाइक, एंड इफ सपोज मिडल ऑफ द डे यू गेट द टाइम, सम पीपल आर वर्किंग एंड ओके आई हैव 1 hour ऑफ लंच एंड आउट ऑफ दैट 1 hour आई एम गोना टेक 15 मिनट्स आउट. So you, in Bhagavad Gita also, the practicality is there, you know. Ye nahi ki bhai, you must do this or you must do that. No. Look at your own life. Find a half an hour to sit down somewhere and do it. For me, the best time is when I go on the beach. When my husband wants to walk, I go sit down, you know, on the sand. And that is like 4:35.
Also, when you are doing nothing, time is irrelevant. In other words, 24 hours you have the same time. So it is not like it is morning or 1 o'clock or 2 o'clock. And really works, I'm telling you. But it, when your time comes, you'll be able to do that. So anyway, then I had a couple of more things I wanted to talk
about. Yeah, sure, go ahead.
So one is I finished my book.
Oh, congratulations!
Wow!
Now
it's ready. So I'm now going to go to the next stage of editing. The third thing is...
Oh. You did fast.
No, not fast. It was almost there. It's just Hindi I was doing.
When did it finish, Joe?
I finished yesterday. I gave it for a review to somebody.
Yesterday?
They pointed out, And okay. They pointed out that these things you have to rearrange. So I ended up rearranging that. And I used this Grammarly program to find all the errors I had. Mm. So it's kind of done.
So I want to tell you one interesting thing, Joe. Remember, I was working on the translation for over a year, 13, 14 months ho gaya usko. My part got finished yesterday also.
Oh, great.
So that is some... and Darshna Ben, you know, said, oh, you know, she was very happy that... I said, Purna huti hui meri. The other people are still working on it.
But... Doing good to us.
Huh?
And also, one more thing. Last week, remember I told you some time ago, I've been watching this Radha Krishna music I'm listening.
Yes.
This program on TV called Radha Krishna.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a dialogue between Radha and Krishna. Mm-hmm. And I was really having an experience with that.
Mm-hmm.
And that experience reached the peak last week when I actually got lost. It was not the Radha part, but the Krishna part, it was only one part. And I don't know how to explain that because... You can only feel it. You cannot tell it about it. Like initially I had the Radha part, then I had the both part. And they both go together actually, you know. So, and it's all in the music. Mm-hmm. That's a wonderful...
The link of this Radha Krishna thing?
It is... are you talking about the one that is like... that they are showing them as young? The Radha Krishna karke naam hai uska.
This is on YouTube. You told me that there's a program which they are doing every week they do.
Yeah, they're doing it on Hotstar. Pe aata hai wo.
Yeah,
it's called Radha Krishna. Abhi bhi chal raha hai. Yeah.
But the music is so good. And
ab link bhej dena.
YouTube pe jao na Radha Krishna.
Bas wohi likhna hai. Okay.
Then you will see it. But you have to feel the music. It's so amazing and the words are so good. And it's Viraya involved in that, which I think started long time ago with my other thing I watched, which was the Bandis Bandit. Remember, there was a Viraya thing.
It was a nice one episode, yeah.
Yeah, there's a music, Viraya song, you know.
Hmm.
And
Joe, there are a lot of them. There are a lot of YouTube videos on Radha Krishna.
Oh, yeah, right. So you have to find the right.
I think they all are looking for the one you liked.
when Krishna is going,
eight link bhejna, then we can watch it.
No, when Krishna is going to Mathura and Radha is sad, and she said, "I'm gonna miss you," and he's saying that you are not gonna miss me because I'm within you, and also they are beautiful words, you know.
Yeah,
I saw one episode which I'm going to send you all. They're saying actually Radha and Krishna actually married. When Krishna and then Brahma ji ne unki shaadi karayi thi.
Right.
Oh. There's a banki or some
marriage
garden is there in Vrindavan. And bole usi garden mein aap ja sakte ho only if you were present at that time 5,000 years ago. And only those people can go to that garden, it seems. So I'm going to send you all that video. Okay. Jaise wo, actually, Brahma ji ne...
They have made a lot of stories, but... Really, what they are talking about is not the physical world. It is the spiritual love world.
Yeah, that's...
Like love is everywhere we say, and that's why I was asking the question, what is love? And everybody explained. But these were dutiful love you were talking about. Nothing to do with the love.
You're talking about the pure, pure unconditional love you're talking about.
Yeah.
That we can, we have to go beyond.
When you hear that, you feel that.
I see.
In fact, one of the small video they had, she's playing the flute and the flute changes to Krishna is playing the flute. And it's so amazing the way they did the transition between her and the tune is the same, but they play from one to another, you know. So it's really...
Yeah, I've watched the whole series and I'm still watching it. And it has a lot of, it has a double meaning, like you're saying. There are a lot of worldly stories and all that, but underneath it, it's a pure love story.
Right.
Yeah, that's how it is.
So they have done it very beautifully because they have kept the...
Who is the director?
The oneness of the Krishna.
I don't know who the director is. Yeah. But the people who played this Radha and Krishna, they look so amazing. And I think what they said was that they copied this Hare Krishna mein jo murti hoti hai na, uska jo personification kiya unhone, unke matlab shringar mein.
Bahut hi badhiya. Actually, I never felt like that before. I mean, I watched so many things, but this was done probably very timely because one of the chapter of mine is Krishna and love. So I added that in there. Anyway, so
okay, I think that मेरा time हो गया unfortunately. तो
आपका short लगना है दूसरा.
हाँ हाँ.
अच्छा good luck.
Thank you.
उसके बाद तो दो दिन गड़बड़ होगी.
Yeah, I'll see क्या होता है. पहले मैं मेरे को.
What you should do now? What I did yesterday was I was just moving my arm when I was waiting for the 15 minutes.
I see.
तो उसमें pain नहीं होगा.
मुझे पहले वाले में काफी कम रिएक्शन हुआ है तो अभी
पहले में बहुत कम होता है.
अच्छा सेकंड में ज्यादा होता है.
यू मे नॉट हैव एनी रिएक्शन. या आई डिडंट हैव एनी रिएक्शन. सो दैट्स एवरीबॉडी डजंट.
बट एनीवे द नेक्स्ट